This video shows how to test a MOSFET in a very basic way. I made a circuit to test the MOSFET. It's here. And it works according to these principles. I hope I can explain that now. This is an N MOSFET. An N MOSFET has its drain on the plus and its source on the minus. And when we add a small positive charge to the gate, the MOSFET starts to conduct between the drain and the source, this lead, and in this lead there is our load. And this load can be a lamp or a coil, transformer to switch something. And you can also test use this circuit in real when you use here a 100 nanofarad capacitor and here 10 volts. First charge the capacitor by moving the switch to the plus, then connect the switch to the gate, and you will see that the lamps light up for a short moment as long as the charge flows from the capacitor into the gate, the positive charge. The whole circuit can be copied to a circuit in which we test a P MOSFET. Now we reverse the power supply here. The P MOSFET starts to work when the gate gets a negative voltage or a negative charge. So at first connect the capacitor to the minus and then switch it to the gate, and you will see that the lamps light up for a short time till the charge in this capacitor has flown away, has flown into the gate. So these are in fact the principles of this circuit here. This is the circuit that I've showed here, and it's how I made it. With this switch you can reverse the polarity. So when we move the contacts to this side, plus and min here are changed. This is the MOSFET under test, and here is a potentiometer. And when we take an N MOSFET and we slowly turn the potentiometer to the plus, the MOSFET will conduct and both lamps light up. I will show it now. This is an N MOSFET. Here's the potentiometer. I turn it now to the min, the minus, and you can see that both lamps light up, and that means that current flows from the plus here through the lamp from the drain to the source to the minus. So here we take our load. The button switches are connected here to show how the load will react in two different situations. So when the load is connected in the drain lead from the drain to the plus or the minus, or in the source lead. And there are different effects when you drive the MOSFET. So when I push this switch, I can see how the load, in this case a lamp, reacts in the drain lead. And when I push this switch, I see how the load reacts in the source lead. I cannot turn the potentiometer now because the camera is in my other hand, but when you make the circuit you can see the different effects, and you can conclude that in the drain lead there is a bigger voltage jump. So in the drain lead you can connect the load, and that has the best switching effects. That was my conclusion. But of course you can also connect your load in the source lead, It differs and it depends. It's the way you want to use the MOSFETs. This capacitor I have already explained. This capacitor can be charged by connecting it to the plus or to the minus, and then let the charge flow away into the gates. Here you see two LEDs. One is a red LED and one a green one. They are here, and they indicate how the polarity from the circuit is. So when I switch this, when I move this switch, I can reverse the polarity, and we can also see the effects on the MOSFET. So now I don't connect the plus and minus properly to this MOSFET. This is an N MOSFET, but now the polarity on the drain and the source is not correct. And when I turn the potentiometer, the lamps light up constantly, and that's not normal. So when you connect a random MOSFET, by turning this switch, you can find whether it's a P MOSFET or an N MOSFET. Now I connect the, I reverse the polarity, and the N MOSFET is connected properly. And when I turn the potentiometer again, you can see that the current through the drain, in the drain and the source lead, is pinched off. I want to show an application from the MOSFET now. Oops, this is an earlier circuit on my YouTube channel. It's the multivibrator, and this multivibrator drives this MOSFET. It has a reversed transformer in the drain lead. And now on the secondary of this transformer, there's a high voltage. Be careful with this kind of circuits, they can be lethal in a very bad case. So I switch off the light now. And you can see that the fluorescent tube lights up well. And when I change the frequency, you can also see the effects. The MOSFET is driven on the gate. Now I raise the voltage. So it's a little bit noisy, this inverter circuit, but it's useful. I hope I have explained some things about the use of a MOSFET, and I wish you luck and success.